Again to Cartesian Enterprise. Here at Cartesian Enterprise, we help guide farmers on how to start up and scale up in the Cartesian business. So today we are back with a brand new episode and we are looking at 20 amazing facts in a catfish farm. 20 amazing facts that some people don't know about a catfish. So we are looking at the 20 amazing facts in catfish. So stay tuned as we give you the 20 amazing facts. We are looking at the 20 amazing facts about the catfish. Now the number one, there are more than 3,000 species of the catfish that can be found on the continent except the Antarctica. Isn't that wonderful? So the catfish have more than 3,000 species, and some countries you might just see one or two that is doing well in that country, while there are some others that can't do well in that place. So they have more than 3,000 species of the catfish. So it's the species are large. It's not, you can't list them all. So we have more than 3,000 species of the catfish found across the continent. So we move to the second one. Now the number two is the smallest species of the catfish are the banjo catfish. It's only 0.39 inches long. Wow, that's the smallest species of the catfish. Now we say that catfish have different types of species, but for the smallest is the banjo fish. Now we move on to the number three. Now the largest, we just saw the smallest. Now the largest is the Mekong fish and can reach nearly 9 feet in length and 646 pounds in weight. Marvelous, the size is big. Now these are facts you might not know about a catfish. Now because maybe those farmers that rear the catfish, you might not get up to this size or this species to train. Imagine the pond that you want to use for a 9 feet fish, so it should be a massive pond. Now we move ahead and we are looking at the number four. Is that a catfish can be silver gray, white, tan, green, yellow, depending on the species. So the catfish has different colors depending on the species you are rearing. Now we saw that banjo fish is greenish gray in nature. Now, and there are so many colors of the catfish. We have the green, we have the, so the different species has their different color. Now this is amazing also. So we also move on to the next one, which is number five. The catfish can survive from 8 to 20 years in the wild, depending on the species. 8 to 20 years, wow. Seeing a 20-year-old fish, to be celebrating his birthday by then. So wonderful. So there are a lot of amazing facts about a catfish. So it can stay up to 8 to 20 years in the wild. Now, in the wild, not in your pond. In the wild, so you can stay up to that amount, 8 to 20 years in the wild. So very soon we are going to be seeing a 20 years old fish in our one of our next episode. So we also, let's move on. We have seen five amazing facts about the catfish. Now the number six. Now they said the greatest concentration of sensory organs is located on the whiskers, also known as the barbels. Catfish develop up to 4 whiskers. Now the barbels, that's why if the catfish merely you just come close to it, it shifts. You can't grab the barbels or the whiskers. So they have catfish that develop all to 4 of that. So that has is the sensory organ for catfish. It can use to detect maybe danger, it can use to detect when things are not going right. Now we move on and we get to the seventh one. As most species of the catfish has a smooth skin without scales covered with mucus. A lot of catfish, they don't have scale, like you see, like in our Nigerian setting, all the catfish we have here, there's nothing like a scale, it's just a mucus. That's why it's hard to grab them with your hand. You might need to use a towel or hold them firmly, if not they'll slip out from your hand. So they are covered with mucus. The body of the, so they don't cover with scale. So any fish you see with scale is not the catfish. So let's move on to the number eight. Now the catfish has over 27,000 taste board. Wow, amazing. Over 27,000 taste board. Amazing. That's why if you give them a bad or a feed that is not good, they'll just leave it for you to eat yourself. They have more than 27,000 taste board. That's an amazing fact. So go to the number 9. Catfish are bottom dwellers. They feed on the bottom of the water. Yes, catfish in the wild are bottom dwellers, so they eat the sinking feed in the wild. So they are bottom dwellers. And this also will now take us to the number 10 of the amazing facts in the catfish farm. And they say cultivated species of catfish are trained to eat pellets that float on the surface of the water against their natural instinct. Like we saw in the number 9, they are bottom dwellers. Now, but the ones you see in the pond that eat the pellets, the floating pellets, have been trained to do that. Yes, you give them the pellets, and over time they now get accustomed to it, start eating the floating feed. Now, why a lot of persons want to make use of that so they can monitor the feeding rate and they can monitor if they are wasting much on feeding. So those, if you are using maybe the sinking feed, most times you might not be able to monitor their feeding rate and that. So they are being configured, they are being transformed to eat on the surface of the water. That's an amazing aspect of the catfish. But in the wild, they are bottom dwellers. Now, we have come to the halfway of our amazing fact. Now, number 11 says the catfish are carnivorous. That means they are meat eaters. Now, their diet is basically on fishes, insects, worms, frogs, or nets. So, they are carnivorous in nature. So, they can eat fishes, eat insects, worms, or frog. So, any worm you see going to your pond, that's turned to a meat for them. So, I know a lot of persons that feed their fishes with worms. Maybe you see a frog in your pond, sorry, it is meat for them to eat, except maybe the fishes are maybe they are the fingerling stage while they are still small, but a bigger fish will turn them to meat. So let's move on. Number 12, now the main predators of catfish are large fishes, birds, reptiles, mammals, and humans. Yeah, these are the main predators of the catfish. Now, that's why you see bigger fishes, they can just swallow the smaller ones. That's why they sort in the pond. If you are training the fishes, you have to sort them to the different sizes so that the big ones don't eat the small ones, or even the small ones gang up to eat the big ones. And also the birds. That's why most farms, you see them with nets. They cover the farm with nets so that birds don't come and pick them up. Now, they have mammals, reptiles, and different stuff that can eat them, and also humans is also a predator of the catfish. So you can see the picture we have in the screen. We have a roasted catfish ready for consumption. Now let's move on to the number 13 of the amazing fact. Now the young catfish are called the sack fry because they still live off the food supplied by the yolk sac. Yeah, the fries. When you do the hashing, now they are called the fries at that stage. So once they are at that fry stage, immediately they don't start eating the foreign feed already. So they eat from the yolk of the, so that's why they are called the sack fries. Now we'll move on to the next one, which is the number 14. Now they say when the catfish reach 4 inches long, they are called a fingerling. Now the size of the index finger, so they are still small, so they call them the fingerling at that stage. So they move from the sack flies and they enter the fingerling stages. So as they grow, they have names for them. They have what called the post fingerling, the juvenile, the post juvenile, and so on. Now let's move on. The number 15. Now, wow, they said Asian walking catfish is a species of catfish that can move on the ground using its front fin and tail. So it's called the Asian walking catfish. Now it can move from one body of water to another. If there's water somewhere, it can just say, oh, I don't like this water, let me move to the other one. So also we move on to the next one, which is the number 16 on our list today. Now they say catfish are able to produce and detect sounds thanks to their Weberian apparatus, bony structure we connect swimming bladder and auditory system, so they can detect sound from a far distance. Yes, they can produce and also they can detect. They can produce sound, they can detect sound. Now if you want to check that out, go close to a pond and just make a sound and you see the fishes will respond to it. It might not just be on the pond, but just maybe they are not seeing you, you are far, but you just make a sound, will respond to that sound. So they can detect sound. They are good detectors. So we'll move on to the next one, which is the number 17 on our list. Now the catfish produce sound by rubbing together body parts or by inducing vibration of the swimming bladder. Yeah, we saw that earlier that in the number 16 that they can produce sound, and they say this sound is produced by rubbing together their body parts. Yeah, if you go to the pond, you just be hearing noises, pa, 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 pa. That means they are making sound, so they are jubilating, they are just enjoying themselves, making beats. So if you're an artist, you can meet them for a beat. So we move on to the number 18 on the list. Now there's some species of the catfish produce poisons in the gland in the skin that cover the dorsal fin. Yeah, there are some species that have this gland. So now they use it in case of an attack, so it can strike you. So you should avoid those species of catfish. Now let's move on to the number 19. And you say the catfish can be active during the day and the night, or at dawn and dusk, depending on their species. So depending on the species, depending on the time, they'll be active. Some will be security and some will be working. So the species, depending on how they function. Bear in mind, we say they have more than 3,000 species of the catfish, so you might not be able to know all of them. So the last on the list, which is the number 20, is the mating season for the catfish species take place in the late spring and the early summer. Now for those using the artificial pond, you might not be able to witness this. You do the artificial hatching and the rest, but in the wild, that's what goes on. So thank you for joining us in the 20 amazing facts about the catfish farm. Until next time, stay blessed. This is the Catfish Farm Enterprise. Hit on the subscribe button and we are ready to give you more and more insights about the catfish farm. Thank you.